Hey guys, it's Josh Stern.
And Mike Walters.
With the Stern team virtually. So we're super focused on keeping you guys informed in this time of a shifting real estate market. So you have all of the knowledge to make good decisions when it comes to your own home selling, buying, or investing goals. And today we wanted to address some of the questions that we received about potential housing crash. First of all, I hope that you and your loved ones continue to stay safe and healthy. The coronavirus continues to be a big topic of conversation and dominates every aspect of our life right now. And with all the volatility in the stock market, the uncertainty about the length of time this is going to last, a lot of folks are rightfully concerned about another Great Recession or a market crash like we had in 2008 to 2011. Right? I think Ali Wold, who was the director of economic research for the real estate consulting firm, Myers Research? So she addressed this point in a recent interview, and here's what she said. With people having PTSD from the last time, they're still afraid of buying at the wrong time. And Mike, that's totally valid. So let's talk about this, all right?
Yeah, and there's quite a few reasons indicating that this real estate market is nothing like 2008. And here's five of them. First is, in the last 30 days, more homes have offers accepted on them than are coming available for purchase here in the Utah market in most major metropolitan areas.
Right.
Also, mortgage standards are nothing like they were back then. Have you seen that movie, The Big Short? Well,
oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can't fog a mirror and then get a loan anymore. So standards for underwriting aren't tough. Getting a loan isn't hard to do, but you actually have to qualify for that loan. No more stated income loans or proverbial 80-20 combo loans.
Okay.
The third point is we don't have a surplus of homes on the market. And as I mentioned, we have a surplus of buyers. In fact, we actually have a shortage of homes available, Josh.
Yeah, it's true. You know, Mike, I mean, just looking back, just the last 45 days since Governor Herbert had declared a state of emergency for Utah, we've had almost 4,000 homes come onto market. We've had an incredible 4,700 homes go under contract in that same period of time, and 4,700 of them have closed. So yeah, we've got a shortage of housing, right?
Yeah, we do. Yeah. We do. You know, also, when you think about this, houses, you know, back in 2008 became too expensive in the lead up to the Great Recession, and affordability was a real issue, though it didn't factor into getting a loan. Mm-hmm. The affordability index, which is simply a percentage of the average person's income it takes to buy an average price home, is far lower than it was from 2005 to 2007.
Mm-hmm.
A major player in affordability has been historically low interest rates.
Yeah.
And finally, people are equity rich and not tapped out. Mm-hmm. From 2005 to 2008, people were using their homes like piggy banks, and banks were more than happy to give out nearly free home equity loans for more than their home's real value.
Yeah,
and the result were people were actually using the equity from their homes to finance their lifestyles, you know, weddings, vacations, etc. And that put their homes at risk in the event that they were unable to afford them because they had no equity to sell.
Right.
Well, banking institutions have put a lot of restrictions in place to prevent people from over encumbering their homes.
Yeah, that's cool. I mean, I was through that, selling real estate through the Great Recession, and all of those are incredibly valid points. So thank you so much for sharing that. We are going to continue to keep you guys informed about the real estate industry and what's happening during these very trying times. But don't hesitate to just give us a call. You can ask us about our Safe Seller program or our Virtual Buyer program that our clients are currently utilizing to stay safe during these COVID times.